If you want to support the channel, then please check out my Patreon page to gain access to exclusive videos, take part in Q&As, and watch my retrospectives before they go live on YouTube. The live-action film of Sonic the Hedgehog hit cinemas in February of 2020, based on the popular Sega video game character that arrived on a Sega Mega Drive back in 1991, and has had endless amounts of sequels and spin-offs released over the years. Just recently, it arrived on Blu-ray and DVD, and is also available to rent on streaming platforms. The film was directed by Jeff Fowler, who had only directed a short movie called Gopher Broke, which received an Academy Award nomination. Budgeted at around $90 million, it managed to gross over $300 million worldwide, making it the most successful video game to movie adaptation released in the USA. It could have been a massive failure though. Once the first trailer hit the internet in April of 2019, the look of Sonic was universally panned, and it wasn't just the fans of Sonic complaining. Apparently, Paramount Pictures expected Sonic fans to object to the new look, but they felt general audiences wouldn't care, but they were wrong. Sega themselves weren't entirely happy with the redesign, especially Sonic's eyes. The film studio made the right decision to delay the movie by 3 months, and spent an additional $5 million to redesign Sonic to mirror his classic image. There had been talk of a Sonic movie since the mid-90s, following a similar approach to Roger Rabbit, with an animated version of Sonic interacting with actors. All other ideas was to go in the direction of a fully animated movie. But there was a reluctancy from Sega due to the failure of Super Mario Bros. They didn't want the reputation and image of their character to be damaged, and the rights to develop a live-action movie was shelved. Interest grew again in 2013 when Sony had wanted to push forward with a feature, but again the idea was put on hold, and it was Paramount Pictures who gave it the green light and got the film off the ground in 2017. The majority of the cast signed on by August 2018, and principal photography was set up in Vancouver, starting in September and finishing in October. For the film's plot, Sonic has been living on Earth since he was a kid. He escaped from his homeworld after being sought after by a tribe for his power. His guardian, an owl called Longclaw, gives him a bag of rings which he can use to create portals between worlds. Stuck on Earth by himself the remaining years in the town of Green Hills in Montana, he has been keeping an eye on the locals, but longs to make a friend. He idolizes the local sheriff Tom and his veterinarian wife Maddie, unaware the pair are planning to relocate to San Francisco soon. One night, Sonic becomes frustrated by his loneliness when playing baseball by himself, and runs at supersonic speed as a result, accidentally triggering an electromagnetic pulse that knocks out the power across the Pacific Northwest. Dr. Robotnik is enlisted by the United States Department of Defense to uncover the source of the outage. Robotnik discovers and tracks Sonic's footprints to Green Hills thanks to his drone technology. Sonic notices the government are on his case, and he hides in Tom's shed. Tom discovers Sonic and accidentally shoots him with a tranquilizer, causing him to send his bag of rings through a portal to San Francisco. Tom reluctantly agrees to help Sonic to get his rings back, as the pair evade the eccentric Dr. Robotnik. Robotnik comes across one of Sonic's quills, discovering the power in it has the potential to fuel his robots. He then becomes obsessed with capturing Sonic to harness his power for himself. Now, I didn't get the chance to see Sonic in theatres. I wasn't desperate to rush out and see it. I grew up playing Sonic and its sequels on the Mega Drive, and Sonic Adventure when it hit the Dreamcast. I enjoyed those games, but I never considered myself a super fan of the character. The games were just fun to play. I've been a bit surprised Sonic has continued to have a strong fanbase over the years, especially with younger audiences. From what I've seen and played of the more recent games of the last decade or so, they have largely been rubbish or just lack the charm and strong gameplay of the earlier titles from the 90s. Sonic has somewhat struggled with the leap from 2D to 3D, far less successful than Mario, who has had hit after hit. The recent release of Sonic Mania demonstrated that Sonic works best in a 2D medium, and it's probably the best Sonic game I've played since Sonic 2. I just wish this game came out on a Sega Saturn in the late 90s. I had heard from many people that this Sonic film wasn't too bad, and certainly wasn't the disaster many people were expecting, and those opinions are true. It's perfectly fine. It is, however, average and plays it very safe and doesn't do anything original with its story. Sonic with the early games never really had a plot. Things were of course expanded over the years in further games and the long-running comic book series, but the film just follows a very familiar storyline that is very predictable, cliched, and doesn't make any large attempts to spend time in the world of Sonic. It quickly gets to Earth and spends 95% of the time there. The film's most frustrating aspect is Sonic himself, sadly. He does have some nice gags at work and got a few chuckles out of me, but the majority of the time I just found him a bit irritating. He's hyperactive, never shuts up. It's like you're dealing with a kid high on sugar. Also, I didn't think the voice fit the character. It's always been a bit weird once Sonic started speaking in the games. Of course, there had been a cartoon, but I don't think they never fully got his voice right. Their direction, from what it appears to me, is to have him sound cool and edgy. To me, I felt Sonic should be a bit sarcastic and witty, a bit like Raphael from Ninja Turtles. He should be a bit lazy as well, making it ironic that he is the fastest thing on a planet, but he is a bit of a slob. His whole goal and the theme of the movie is about friendship, not the most exciting idea put to film. Sonic just wishes to make a friend so he doesn't feel so alone. Thankfully, the redesign makes him look more familiar to his classic video game image, but Sonic has always looked a bit off in 3D. I prefer the chubby 2D version of Sonic from his early days. Despite being nicely animated, it doesn't quite fit the live-action elements very well. It doesn't seem to blend naturally, and it ends up looking like a cartoon character that has just been superimposed into the movie. Jim Carrey is certainly the highlight as Dr. Robotnik. He brings back his over-the-top comedic style from his 90s output of movies such as Ace Ventura and Batman Forever, which was nice to see again. The comedy doesn't quite hit the marks in all his scenes. He is trying his best to elevate the comedy, but the jokes aren't strong enough in the script. It was a nice touch to have Sonic refer to him as Eggman, which is his name in Japan. Robotnik is supposed to be an overweight man, and Jim Carrey is far from it, but he does look more like the classic villain by the end of the film. James Marsden, who I'm always happy to see, a good actor and has great comedic timing, but he doesn't really get the chance to be funny. He just plays a generic nice guy who is stuck in a boring town as a police officer who wants to escape to the big city and comes to the help of Sonic and befriends him. It's just unfortunately a forgettable role for James. One of my favourite characters is the cop called Wade, played by Adam Pally. A small role, but his character is very funny and got a lot of laughs from me. I just wish he was in it more. He should have joined Sonic for his adventure, to be honest.
No one's gonna erase my memory here. I will tell people about this!
When Sonic utilises his super speed, we end up with sequences we've seen before in recent movies and even TV shows. Watching Sonic play baseball by himself feels like a scene ripped from the old Lois and Clark TV show. Seeing the scene of him moving at normal speed with everyone essentially frozen in time is ripped from X-Men Days of Future Past. It's all stuff you've seen before. I suppose this was the difficult aspect for the filmmakers. What else can you do with Sonic that hasn't already been done before with, say, The Flash or Quicksilver? So in this area, they seem to struggle to do anything original. The film's visual effects are genuinely okay. They do the job, but nothing looks photorealistic. It very much looks like you are staring at computer effects. The score by Tom Holkenborg, aka Junkie XL, does a serviceable job. He provides a classic symphonic score with some soft rock, a big departure from his electronic approach. His stuff on Batman v Superman was headache-inducing. It felt like I was being bashed over the head with a keyboard. Oddly, Tom doesn't take any inspiration from the Sonic games, using the very recognisable themes and melodies. I did hear one theme near the end that is a slow rendition of the Sonic main theme, but that's all I noticed. For once, Tom should have gone with an electronic score with some jazz thrown in, and adapted many of the classic themes from the game to just please the fans. What we got seemed like a missed opportunity. The film leaves it open for a sequel, and from its success at the box office, I would imagine that Paramount would want to do a follow-up, and hopefully they'll feature more of Sonic's world. If you have children, then I'm sure they'll have a lot of fun watching it. Since Super Mario Bros. In 1993, there has been a lot of movies based on video games. Most of the time they fail at capturing the games, as it's a difficult medium to translate, and often the filmmakers don't really care about the game, but just see an opportunity to profit from the IP. Sonic the Hedgehog doesn't come across as a cynical cash grab, but it doesn't really do anything interesting with the famous hedgehog. It's understandable that they wouldn't push things too far with the first film, because there is a risk it could be a disaster, and to their benefit it worked in their favour. It's definitely up there as one of the stronger adaptations of a video game, but that really isn't saying much considering the best of the video game movies for me is Mortal Kombat, which isn't a cinematic masterpiece, but just an enjoyable action film. Thankfully, Sonic is far better than, say, Double Dragon, the Resident Evil movies, Dead or Alive, and Mortal Kombat Annihilation. I do have to remind myself this film is aimed at kids and not people who are in their late 30s, but then again, that age bracket who grew up watching Sonic during his golden years are in their 30s to 40s, so it would still appeal to them in some way, and I did laugh a few times watching it. It wasn't an embarrassing mess, put it that way. It was a strange experience for me, however. I would flip-flop a lot while watching it. There would be a scene that irritated me and was way too cheesy, then the next scene was pretty good, just back and forth a lot. But the general enjoyable aspects outweighed the clumsy and negative stuff. If you are a hardcore Sonic fan, then I'm sure you will enjoy it. But for everyone else, it's a harmless movie that will generate some laughs, but it is ultimately throwaway entertainment.